This is my custom-built motorized camera slider. It is completely modular and uses different mechanisms to move the camera. I want to make a slider that can move back and forth and rotate the camera. The two movements should be controlled by one motor. My idea was to use two aluminium profiles as guides and have a cart drive between them, on which the camera would then be placed. There will be a threaded rod on the motor. The nut is then mounted on the carriage. This will allow the cart to move when the motor is rotating. I want the cart to automatically reverse direction when it reaches the end of its path. I do this by using a double pole switch that collides with a block at the two ends. The block will switch the switch and turn the motor in the other direction. I also use an axis that I can set up both straight and diagonally, so that I can rotate the camera. I'll show you exactly how I plan to do that in a moment. I started by drawing some prototype parts, which I could then print and assemble. This is the first test. The cart can already move back and forth perfectly. I notice that the switch offers too much resistance. That's why I am replacing it with a smaller one that has to travel less distance to be switched. The springs will ensure that even if the switch does not switch automatically, the springs will build up tension and the switch will still switch. Now that the prototype is working, I can continue with drawing all the parts, including the rotation mechanism of the camera. This part slides over the axle and it is attached to this part with a ball bearing. This part contains a hexagonal bolt. Because the head of this bolt is not round, it hooks into the part. This will cause it to rotate while moving back and forth. Then I mount the camera on this bolt. Camera will rotate as soon as the axis is set up in a diagonal position. Now that all the parts have been drawn, I can prepare them for the printer. I start with holder 1. On the left side of the screen you always see the materials used and or an animation. Here I make the rotation mechanism. I can easily click the bearing into part 4 and part 3 into the bearing. These remain firmly in place. Now I'm making the end blocks. I can easily click the spring in and it stays in place well. Now I start with the slider. I can easily click the lead screw nut in and secure it with two M3 Allen bolts. On one side I used long bolts and lock nuts to secure the wheels. And on the other side there was also an eccentric nut in between to make it easier to adjust the slider later. I made this lock nut insert tool to make it easier to tighten the lock nuts in the larger holes. A cable channel has been made through the part that goes from the outside to the switch. I can then mount the switch with two M2 bolts. I attach part 3 with three M3 Allen bolts. I also mount a TPU cover over the switch to increase the contact area. In part 2, I can also click a bearing and insert the pre-assembled rotation mechanism into it. The slider is now ready. I start by mounting two TPU feet in holder 2. After this, I mount the motor with four M3 hexagon socket screws. I made two different versions of part 3, one with room for the potentiometer and one without. My power supply already has a possibility to regulate the voltage and therefore the speed of the motor. That's why I continue without the potentiometer. I soldered all the electronics according to this diagram. I soldered several two-wire JST connectors to it to make it easier to assemble later. This slider has a completely modular design, which means that you can determine the length yourself. Only the aluminium profiles, the shaft, the lead screw and the 4-wire cable are variable in length, although they must be matched. I mount this motor coupling on the lead screw and then also on the shaft of the motor. I can insert the aluminium profiles into holder 2 and then secure them with M5 bolts. Before I install the second profile, I first make sure that the slider is properly installed. I have provided two holes in the holder to insert the 4-wire cable so that it ends in the holder and will therefore be nicely concealed in the groove of the profile. Now I mount part 1 of the axis mount. I secure this with an M5 hexagon bolt. I slide the axle through part 3 of the axis mount into the slider and then tighten it. Now I mount the holder on the wrist. I insert the nut into part 3 of the axis mount and then secure it with an M5 bolt. I also secure the profiles with M5 bolts. I mount the switch with two M2 bolts and then push the 12 volt DC connector into place. I connect all the connectors and can close the holder properly with 4 M3 Allen screws. Now I realize that I forgot the end blocks, so I put them in between on the side of the switch. I can easily move this in the slots of the aluminium profiles, and in this way I choose where the slider can move. To mount a phone or camera, I made this little mechanism that I can easily mount. I have made this so that I can easily tighten and loosen the mechanism on the M8 bolt of the slider via this part. This allows me to mount the camera but still rotate it without having to move the slider. I printed this slot cover to hide the cable more neatly. The clampable tripod I made a while ago is fully compatible with the slider. The motorized camera slider is now fully assembled and ready to use. These were all the prototypes I needed to make this slider. You can download all the parts for free on MakerWorld. Like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.